exams either being cancelled or postponed with regularity, lakhs of aspirants are uncertain about the road ahead for them. Another exam, the NEET PG, has been postponed due to logistical issues. This even as NEET UG had to hold a retest for students who received abnormal grace marks this year. Remember, many students are still demanding a total retest for all in that case. CBI team, meanwhile, reached Patna today to investigate the NEET paper leak and sought information from the Bihar Economic Offences Unit on the same. Sources say they will also travel to Godhra in Gujarat, where the other abnormalities have come to light. Opposition is questioning the Prime Minister's silence and demanding Education Minister Pradhan's resignation. This despite the centre assuring that a thorough probe is on and they will take steps to improve the NTA itself. So what has the government done so far? First, the appointment of new NTA DG Subodh Kumar has been put on compulsory waiting. Meanwhile, a new DG in Pradeep Kharola has been appointed. This even as a 7-member panel looks into the functioning of the NTA itself and suggests a course correction. And criminal investigations into the irregularities, including the paper leak, are also on. Finally, the law, which was drafted earlier to address the paper leaks and cheating, has now been notified. Is all of this enough? Exactly who has compromised the system? And is the government being able to do enough to rectify that situation? That debate is coming up.
We all know that the issues of the students, particularly the education system, is fumbling and it is breaking. And the educational system, because of a certain ideology capturing the education system itself, the mediocrity idea in the top positions in all the universities, all the positions of the education system, as the result of that only it is this happening.
सरकार की तरफ से तमाम बातों को मजबूती से और पूरी निरपक्षता के साथ सदन के पटल पर रखा जाएगा. सरकार के पास छुपाने के लिए कुछ भी नहीं है. जो ये हुआ है, इसमें जो भी दोषी हो, भले वो पेपर लीक हो या जिस तरीके से ग्रेस मार्क्स को लेकर छात्रों में चिंताएं रही हैं, ऐसे में उन तमाम बातों को ध्यान दिया जाएगा.
Let's go across to our guest joining us, Radhika Khera from the BJP stays with us. Arshpreet Khadiyal, spokesperson of the Congress, joining us. Dr. Vivek Jain, educationist, and Desh Ratan Nigam, political analyst, leans towards the BJP also with us. Let me begin with Arshpreet Khadiyal first. I've listed out, Arshpreet, some of the steps the government has taken. They're saying, let's be patient, we're reviewing all facets of the case. Criminal investigations are on. But the opposition doesn't seem to be very happy with what the government has announced so far. Why is that?
It's only been a few days of the Modi government 3.0, and in mere 10 days, 4 exams have either been cancelled or they have been postponed. Mm-hmm. And despite 34 lakh families being adversely affected, Mr. Modi, the Prime Minister, hasn't uttered a word. Back in the day when the NEET UG fiasco happened, Mr. Modi prioritized his foreign trips over 24 lakh families. Then after that, the UGC NET exam fiasco happened. And then he prioritized the choosing of the speaker. As if Mr. Modi is unbothered and unaffected with all these families. I want to know it from the Bharatiya Janata Party's government. What problem does the BJP have in ordering a Supreme Court monitored probe in all these matters? Because we cannot trust these agencies. We've all seen how effective they have been. And Mr. Pradhan, back in the day when the first fiasco happened, he said nothing wrong happened. He gave a clean slate without the inquiry being ordered, without the inquiry being concluded, as if he was the judge, jury, and executioner. And for what reason was he giving a clean slate? Is the Bharatiya Janata Party trying to protect someone? Is the Bharatiya Janata Party trying to hide something? Is that the reason as to why they are brushing things
under the carpet? But now an investigation is going on. Are you doubting the veracity of that investigation?
The thing is, Shivani, the education minister first says nothing wrong has happened. Mm-hmm. And then an inquiry is ordered. Is it not contradictory? Is it not exposing the minister? And therefore, should he not be resigning on the basis of that?
Okay.
And second is, Shivani, that till now, you see that the protesting students, an FIR has been registered against them because they were protesting outside Mr. Pradhan's house. Hmm. However, the perpetrators are at large. Why is the Bharatiya Janata Party not trying to do a time-bound inquiry? Whereas the Bharatiya Janata Party, instead of ordering a fast-track disposal of the case, is trying to do a slow-track disposal of the case.
Okay.
The Bharatiya Janata Party needs to come clean on this.
Radhika, you know, this is not just an embarrassment, but also a faux pas, because not only did the irregularities happen, it seemed like the government had no clue. At least the minister in charge had no clue initially, and the NTA also denied it, the minister also denied it. This has come as a massive egg on the government's face. And then on top of that, to pile on the misery, more and more exams are getting cancelled or postponed. There is something terribly wrong. Have you been caught napping?
First of all, the Congress's attempts to politicize the exam leak are nothing short of hypocritical, given their own dismal record of handling the situation, similar incidents in the past. Under our government, Prime Minister Modi's leadership, a thorough investigation has been launched and stringent measures are being taken and being implemented at the same time to ensure that those responsible are held accountable.
No, everything's happening a little bit belated, only when the pressure piles up on you.
No, there's nothing like that. This is not something that needs a short-term thing. We need to get to the root cause. We were given a system that in 54 years had rotted the educational system of the country. We are trying to make changes. It takes time compared to
No, but Radhika, again, years. You know, this is a fallout of...
You can't continuously keep talking in between. You have to let me complete my point.
I got your point. You're saying the same thing
No, you did not get my point. That's why you keep interrupting.
Radhika, this is a continuation of our previous debate. You're saying for 54 years a system existed and therefore this is happening now. How much time does a BJP government need in power before they say that, okay, we've been in power for 10 years or so many years and now this is our responsibility?
So it is our responsibility. That's why we are sorting things out. We are not like the previous regimes that have always turned a blind eye to such critical issues. We have demonstrated zero tolerance for corruption and malpractice earlier, and we will do that today as well, which is why we have removed the DG, which is why that bill that the Public Examination Act of 2024 has been enacted, which is why those people are being taken to task and the investigations are on. We are going to ensure that the children get justice. Not one student is left behind saying that mujhe justice nahi mila. And we will ensure the perpetrators of the crime are dealt with severely and such severe punishment is given to them that no one dares to repeat this again.
The loopholes have to be mended. Desh Ratan Nigam, has the government's reputation plus the NTA's reputation not been dented in a manner that may almost be irreparable, at least for the NTA, given what has happened? Is it not time for us to accept that something has horribly gone wrong? Yes, the system may be imperfect and the system may be too large in a large country like us to, you know, correct 100%. But what is happening is certainly, beyond all imagination.
Shivani, in fact, if you look at the pattern of paper leaks and the cancellations over a period of time, it appears there's a larger game plan at play. So larger conspiracy to destabilize the country and to have some kind of an anarchy and chaos in the country, and which we are seeing. And that patterns lead to that particular conclusion which I am drawing. And certainly there are domestic players and there are probably international players which are also involved. And if you look at the Maharashtra case, the terror funding probably has come into this picture and an FIR has been registered and one person has been arrested out there and one person is on the run. So that aspect is a very serious aspect. Yes, it could have been handled better. There is no doubt about it. But if you look at it, the elections were going on. The entire machinery was busy in elections. The ministers were busy in elections. Probably the mafia took advantage of this. And the people who were involved probably took advantage of this. Even the ministers were not there in their ministries at that point of time. Election Commission had taken the entire machinery because everybody reports to the Election Commission in a way.
Hmm. Okay, the NTA is an autonomous body. Of course, it falls under the aegis of the HRD. I want to ask Dr. Vivek Jain, there has been this acceptance that something needs to be reformed or changed about the NTA itself. What do you think that is? Because this very body was formed not 50, 60 years ago, barely 8 years ago, with the express function that it will be able to handle large nationwide large-scale examinations in a foolproof manner. That aim has certainly not been achieved. So, according to you, what are those changes that the NTA needs?
Yeah, Thanks, Shivani. Shivani, first of all, I like to speak pro-student. I like to first address to the problems the students are facing. NEET PG is one of the most important examination in the professional career of a medical student. This is a PG entrance exam which is given after they have completed their MBBS. So this is for them a chance to choose their professional career. That is the branch they will specialize in, MD or MS, that is medicine, surgery, gynecology, obstetrics or pediatrics. So this is a very important exam for not just them, but the future of healthcare foundation in our country. Now, there are five problems I could identify by what has been going on since last 2 days. Number one, it has created undue mental trauma and stress in the mind of students who have been preparing for this exam since last many months, and in fact, whole MBBS of 5.5 years. Number two, their whole preparation has now been derailed and the strategies have gone haywire. This has led to a lot of anxiety in their mind. Now, number three, it will impact the whole healthcare system also. Delayed examination means the students, PG students, will be joining the medical colleges and hospitals across the country many months late. This will lead to acute shortage of health staff in the country, which will affect the general population. Number four, many of these junior doctors had taken a sabbatical if they were working in a job somewhere just for this exam. So just imagine now they are nowhere to go to. They are suffering financially also because thousands of students had booked hotels, flights, trains. Many of them were accompanied with their parents and family members just for this examination. So just imagine, many of them had even slept by the time this news came, just 12 hours before the actual exam.
And you're talking about the NEET PG exam, yes.
Yeah, NEET PG exam, exactly. And finally, number five, we must remember Indian medical students are considered one of the best in the world. And in their mind, it is creating a lot of trust and faith in the system. And this is something that we have to restore.
So how now will that be restored? At least as far as the NTA is concerned, what would you like to see happen?
Okay, I'll suggest, because it's plain speak, I'll speak in plain words. Just three things I would like to ensure. Number one, the agencies make sure the exam is conducted in a timely manner, right? There should be no delay. In case there is a delay, for whatever the reason may be, the student should be informed at least 90 days well in advance. This will help them calm down and take the exam in the right spirit and right way. Number two, the examination system has to be conducted in a fully transparent manner. Please take relevant measure to ensure that. See, I can speak from my own experience. I appeared in the same exam 20 years ago. At that time, I used to have state PG entrances. At that time also, if anyone does a Google search, you'll be surprised to find that this has been continuing since decades now. Every alternate year or so, we hear about these malpractices being done in the examination. So this is somewhere the health authorities, the health agencies and the ministry has to come forward and take everything.
Transparency is the buzzword, but you know, it's very difficult, at least in the public domain, to really understand where is that transparency lacuna and what needs to be done, because we thought the NTA was to fill exactly these gaps. Limited time, so Arshpreet, I'll give you 30 seconds to just put forward the opposition's demand or the Congress's demand on particulars. In the sense, what is it that you want to see happen? Barring, of course, you know, the political liability that may, that you're talking about, somebody's resignation, etc. But what is the solution here? Because we cannot escape the fact that this is a systemic problem.
Well, the solution is only possible when the inquiry gets concluded. And for that, the Bharatiya Janata Party's government needs to show some intention, needs to show some will and make it time-bound in the first place and give it to the Supreme Court. Have a Supreme Court monitored probe. The BJP government hasn't been able to enlist one single problem, one single demerit of a Supreme Court monitored probe. And number two, let's look at the chronology, Shivani. This is very important. The Bihar Police Economic Offences Wing, it suggests that a paper leak has happened qua NEET UG. After that, Maharashtra government also says that injustice has happened with the students. Both these governments, both these states are NDA states, right? And after that, the education minister says that no paper leak has happened, nothing wrong has happened. And after that, he subsequently orders an inquiry, therefore proves that he was lying back in the day. So my question to the BJP is, on what basis did Mr. Pradhan say nothing wrong happened?
All right.
And if he has said why should Mr. Pradhan, not be sacked for lying?
All right, I got your point. I got your point. Minister's accountability plus time-bound and SC monitored probe. I'll give Radhika the last word. Mr. Nigam wanted to come in very quickly.
In fact, Shivani, if you have to find a long-term solution, The only long-term solution, in my opinion, is the online exam with the code lock given at the half an hour before to all examination centers. Otherwise, these physical examinations are leading to a lot of leakage, and that has to be plugged in.
Okay.
The only possible solution is the online exam with the soft code given right at the end moment.
All right, Radhika, why not a time-bound probe plus, let's say, a probe monitored by the Supreme Court so that everybody can have more faith in it? And secondly, why not accountability set for Dharmendra Pradhan, who refused to accept the fact that there was a paper leak initially?
Well, as things unfolded, we accepted what was happening. You have to have an investigation to know what is happening. And let me make this very clear with utmost responsibility that our government is committed to ensuring transparency and fairness in the examination process. And we are going to ensure that we plug any gaps that are there in the examination system. And there is going to be no compromise. I repeat, there is going to be no compromise that to take any action against those who have who are ensuring that these loopholes are, you know, and they are ensuring the paper leak, etc. But we are also going to take action against those who are trying to politicize this issue. The Congress needs to act responsibility and stop putting, stop trying to make this politicize the whole issue by playing with the future of the students.
Okay.
If they are so serious about it, they have to stop politics. Come up. They are giving their suggestions. We will look into it. We will see which is the best way, which is the best investigation, which will lead to the best solution. And you have
maybe
to wait for that.
Maybe we just have to wait till the committee's recommendations. Supreme Court is already already is hearing the matter as far as NEET UG exam is concerned. So let's just wait and see what happens there. I've run out of time. I do thank all of our guests for joining us.